soon as you say infinity, as we go, that's only a mathematical idea.
Yeah.
I mean, how can anything be infinite? I mean,
I know.
Well,
I mean, in math, you can say it. Like, you can say that a straight line goes on forever, and two parallel lines will never intersect. Well, like,
pi is theoretically infinite.
Yeah.
You know, it never ends.
Well, why is that difficult to grasp, though? That's the real question. Like, why do we need everything to be defined by a very obvious beginning and an end?
Mm-hmm. Because everything we experience has a beginning and end.
Biologically,
because we experience time.
Yeah.
Even time is not experienced everywhere the same way.
Well, time isn't experienced at all if you're not sentient.
True.
Yeah. Or if you live in Arizona.
Yeah.
They whack it off. It's different.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's the I always wondered if like there was a reason why we wanted things to have a beginning and an end. Like, is it because we have our life, and our life has a beginning and an end, all the lives of the people we know?
Yeah.
Well, we definitely have an end. I guess people are obsessed with
that. Do we want things to have a beginning or an end, or are we terrified of beginnings and ends?
That too.
Just the thought of an end is terrible.
That's why we create, gods and religions, is because the idea that life ends and that it's all been for nothing is terrifying to people.
There's a little bit of that. Yeah. There's a little bit of like doing it to create order in the community. Mm-hmm. And there's a little bit of people find mushrooms and they need an explanation what the fuck they're feeling.
It's like our brains are constructed in such a way that we need an end.
Yeah.
We need it, or else you don't understand where am I now
if
there's no end.
My very uninformed theory, which is that first off, that everything is meaningless, but that only the brain damaged are capable of conceiving of meaninglessness. Because our brains are meaning machines, and that we evolved, and it gave us an evolutionary advantage that we give meaning to things. Like I said, this is a table because we say it's a table.
Right.
It's not a table to a cat. That's why a cat will just get up and walk around on it.
Lick its ass on it.
Yeah.
Because it's from a mutual agreement.
Yeah, we agree this is a table.
Right.
And that kind of meaning let us organize our lives, let us be better hunters.
Well, you know what constantly occurs to me and bothers me is that we decide not to drive into each other because we've painted a little line on a road down the middle.
Yeah.
We've all agreed not to cross that line.
That's what I'm saying. We ascribe meaning to objects, and that gave us an advantage over other animals. And so our brains just evolved. And then when we got to the point where we realized we're going to die, we go, well, there's got to be some meaning there too. So then we had to create myths that created meaning about our lives.
That's a very the dangerous loop of there's no meaning to everything and nothing has meaning. That's a dangerous loop for a person psychologically, because you can get stuck in that you can really
But I don't think you can, because it's impossible to conceive of unless you are seriously brain damaged.
Well, no, I don't think it's impossible to conceive. It's you won't
you can intellectually think about it, but you can't grasp it, really.
Isn't living in the now kind of the same as life has no meaning?
No.
Because you're not thinking about the future. You're
not thinking about the fact that it has no meaning. You're enjoying
the meaning.
Now with
meaning.
You're enjoying the meaning?
You're enjoying life. You're enjoying experience. You're enjoying each interaction with people. Yeah. You're enjoying your thoughts. I think that the